Hi, I'm Kaylee from Arca Space, and this week we're going to focus on the Aerospike engine itself, as well as take a look at the technical characteristics of the Demonstrator 3.
Intensive tests were performed on the Lunar Aerospike by NASA and Rocketdyne, as it was intended to be the main propulsion for the Venture Star. However, $1.5 billion into the program and it was canceled. This wasn't due to the engine itself, but rather to unrelated fuel tank problems. Because of this, no Lunar Aerospike engine has ever been sent to space or has even been flight tested. With the Demonstrator 3, we intend to do both. We intend to continue on the foundation built by NASA and develop a fully functional Lunar Aerospike.
So right here, we have the positive mold for the engine. Cosmin and Dimitri, they actually just cast one half of the final mold, which I am now removing the foil from. And then tomorrow, we're gonna cast another one of these, screw them together, and then create the final mold. So for the Demonstrator 3 rocket, what we plan to do is conduct some flight tests utilizing a smaller version of our full-size Aerospike. The aim is to gather as much data as possible.
So here we have the negative mold for the Aerospike engine of the Demonstrator 3. One way to think about the shape of the Aerospike is if you take a traditional bell nozzle and invert it. So on the one side, we still have a solid surface on which the exhaust is pressing to create thrust. But on the other side, the exhaust is free to expand depending on what altitude it's at. The problem with a bell nozzle is that they can only be calibrated for one altitude. If the atmospheric pressure is too high or too low, then the exhaust is constricted, resulting in a loss of efficiency. The Aerospike, however, is able to maintain its efficiency across the entire range from ground level to space.
The Demonstrator 3 rocket has a length of 10 meters and a diameter of 0.7 meters. The empty weight is 120 kilograms and the takeoff weight is 2.2 tons. The Aerospike rocket engine has a thrust of 4.2 tons and is running for 85 seconds, which is enough to put the Demonstrator 3 rocket on a ballistic suborbital trajectory at an altitude of more than 100 kilometers. During this flight test, we are going to find if the Aerospike really is the most efficient rocket engine in the world. We truly believe that the only way to dramatically decrease the cost of spaceflight is by using new state-of-the-art technologies instead of improving old technologies.
And that's it for this week's episode. Please make sure to leave your questions in the comments section and stay tuned for next week's episode. See you next time on Flight of the Aerospike.